Hi, in this video we're going to talk about how to use a graphing calculator to find the regression equation if we're doing linear correlation. So we have this problem, it's in the section 10.3 notes that says, can crickets really predict the temperature? So some people claim that there's a linear relationship between the temperature and the number of times a cricket chirps in 1 minute. So the following data was collected from 8 random crickets. So we have how many times these crickets were chirping per minute and the temperature outside. Okay, so just like we've done in previous sections, to put this in, we're gonna hit stat, edit. We're gonna put the chirps per minute in L1. Remember, if you need to erase this, you go up to the top, hit clear and enter. And L2, we'll clear that one too. Okay, so in L1, we're gonna put the chirps per minute. So 882. 1188, 1104, 864, 1200, 1032, 960, and 900. Okay, now we'll also put the 8 values in L2 for the temperature it was outside. 68, 93, 84, 76, 89, 83, 72, and 80. Okay, now that we have that in there, okay, we're gonna go stat, over to calc, and we're gonna choose lin reg number 4, AX plus B. Okay, now if you don't see this, it's okay, you'll just hit enter. But you want, if you do have this menu, you're gonna have L1, L2, and then we'll hit calculate. Okay, and so you should have this. Remember, if you're missing the R value to check to see if there is linear correlation, you'll need to do diagnostic on, which I explained in a previous video. Okay, so if we go through the problem, our correlation coefficient here we can see is 0.869. Okay, the threshold value we got from the chart was 0.707. This is all from the previous section. Since it is greater, there is linear correlation. Now, to get what's called the regression equation, the equation that models this, since it would be in a line, okay, our A, here it gives you what order you put it in, AX plus B. So A is the slope, just like you've seen before, MX plus B. So we'll round to a couple decimal places. So here we'd round the A to 0.054, okay, that's our slope, times X, plus, and then our Y-intercept, the B, comes from the B here, 25.87. Okay, so that's our regression equation. So then it says, if a cricket chirps 980 times in 1 minute, predict the temperature. So you would put the 980 in for X, and you can predict the temperature. So again, you're really putting the data in L1 and L2, and then you're doing stat, calc, the lin reg, and that will give us our equation. We put the A in for the slope and the B in for the Y-intercept.